Afternoon, everyone. My name is Jivan Kaushya, and I'm assistant professor in medical university in law. This paper is basically the review-based paper and secondary database paper. So I'm not saying that it is a research, meaning the first-hand data. So that's why it is like the introductory part that these techniques are utilized in forensic odontology, right? So that many speakers have already discussed these techniques. That I have collected that from the different specialists that which techniques are going to be utilized in forensic odontology and using in a recent scenario. So as we know, the TSP are the most foremost hardest and strong tissue of the human body.
Excuse me, Sivam, can you do this in a full mode, like a slideshow mode? Yeah, it's fine now.
So as we know that in after the skeletonization of the body, the part remaining in cases is the dentition part, right? Or the teeth, we can say. Meaning, in most of the cases, they will found the teeth because they are very protected from the face, and also the structure of the teeth already we know that it is because of the enamel and the characteristic it is safe in the nature, so that the particular odontology helps in forensic investigation for identifying the suspect. So what are the various techniques are utilized? First one is bite mark analysis, which is the basically traditional technique used. So bite mark analysis means that a particular bite has been made on human by human or animal teeth on the skin of alive people, cadavers, the dead body, or any unanimated object. So that they can be bite marks can be found on the crime scene, right? So that bite marks can be found on the body, or that can be found on any object on the crime scene. So that bite mark on the victim body can be found in most of the cases like sexual assault cases, or also can be found on the suspect in case of the defense when the victim is defending herself. So that in that case, the bite mark can be found and can be analyzed that you can say and can be photographed using the APF scaling, so that they can be analyzed and will be helped for the purpose of neutralization of the suspect. Next is the radiographs. The radiographs helps in the identification or the individualization of the purpose. For example, in cases of mass disaster cases, flood, or in cases of arson, so that in that cases, the victim body is found and the individualization has to be done. So in that cases, if the records are available, with the dentist, but in India, as we know that the previous speakers and also the presenters have told us that it is very difficult to in India get the radiogram or the dental radiogram. So that, but still the radiographs are very important for identification or individualization of the individual. For example, we can identify the filling in the teeth. The individual has in turn the filling, or the size of the crust, or the shape of the crust, or for the age determination, the pulp size that Dr. Addy has already told us that pulp size can also help for the age determination of the person. So that radiographs are helpful. So there is another type of radiograph which is known as the endodontic radiographs, which are basically concerned with the dental pulp. So that dental pulp, as we know, that helpful if there is any deformity in the pulp of the individual. So that also can be helpful in individualization and also helpful for the age determination. With the size of the pulp, it is found in the graph that the aged person, the pulp size is larger than the youngster ones. Okay, next is the DNA methods. As we know, the DNA methods are basically used for the individualization because we say that that it is the method which correctly identify the individual, only except the twins. But the DNA methods are very costly in nature, but still the DNA techniques are utilized, and we can extract the DNA from the various, there are the various DNA sources from the oral cavity, like the dental tooth, the saliva, and the oral cavity. So from the dental tooth, we can collect the DNA from the pulp, dentine, bone, and cementum. And these are the extraction techniques for collection, means extracting the DNA, like ultrasonic technique, endodontic procedures, grinding, crushing, and for breaking the cementum, there is vertical splitting, horizontal splitting. So individualization can be also done in case of the stimulated saliva. There is a term stimulated, meaning that artificial saliva is given in case of the xerostomia, that is a kind of disease, where the dryness of mouth is done. So the medication, as a medication, the particular solution is given to the diseased person for to remove that dryness of the mouth. So that in that case also that will be helpful for the individualization of the person. That also incision, excision, and biopsy is done for the oral cavity tissue examination or identification, means for finding the DNA sources. The best and the method which are like digital imaging, as we can say, these are the means modern methods, and we are shifting to these methods only because these methods are fast and easy. That's why there is digital imaging. There are the various softwares. The digital imaging has been used. There are also the open source softwares available. And the CBCT scan imaging is also done, and that is also helpful for the examination of antemortem and the postmortem reports if present, and that will be, that are also very helpful for the individualization of the person. This is the 3D imaging model, that how the software that means procedure basically is done. Meaning, first of all, the first scan in that the image is scanned, or the whatever the our dental cast is imaging is done. Of that, after that, the 3D imaging processing is done by the software only, and after that, the comparing is done. So that the first scan data, for example, the 50 individuals are there, and we have to identify a single individual from that. So that with the 3D image model, by like we can say that reconstruction of the in case of the facial reconstruction, that is also helpful with the 3D imaging, and also for example in case of the teeth, so that we can individualize from the group of the people that whose teeth it belongs to, or from means it is very helpful for individualization purpose. So conclusion is that forensic odontology. Every technique has its own importance because it depends on the circumstances and the type of the crime scene. But 3D technique is very easy and sophisticated as compared to, means it is very easy, and it is not, means there will be not much human error as compared to the DNA technique. So that's why we have to be in India. My conclusion is that we should create the dental records database, so that it will be very helpful for the forensic odontologists in investigation to solve the forensic cases. Thank you.